So my talk is about this tool that I wrote. It's called Debug View +++. Sorry. I'll pass it to you in a moment. Very quickly, there's a tool by SysInternals called Debug View. It was from 10 years ago, wasn't updated in a decade, and I still needed it. So, and I thought it would be nice to extend the functionality of it. So I wrote this tool, and it's Windows only right now. And I'm out of breath because of the altitude. It's Windows only right now, and I switched jobs, so now I'm no longer working on Windows, and completely useless to me. So I want to write a portable version of it. I want to give you a quick overview of the functionality that I have. So, and my ultimate goal is to get some enthusiasts to help me build a better version of this. So what we could do, we could, let's see if this happens. Demo effect, of course, that's already open. So it reads the debug for you that are Windows users. It reads the output debug string API, by default. But you can do pipe anything into this. So I want to try to demonstrate. Oh. good point. So let's try to pipe basically standard in, standard out of a process into this program. And you can see here that I'm cycling this, so there are lines coming from standard out, standard error. You can see the process. And if you're not interested in this particular process, you can just say, well, exclude this process, and you will have only logging from other processes. So when I start it again, it will not do anything because I just filtered all the stuff. But if I try to, there's also filters, like this, and let's turn off the process filter. Now we can see some syntax highlighting. You can also say, okay, I'm only interested in cycle messages, so let's only include these. But now I lost all my context. So if these are particularly interesting messages, and you found this particular one, the fifth one particularly important, but because I've now filtered all the other stuff out, I cannot see the context anymore. So open a new view. It's the same view. It's a new view on the same data. So if I found this line, cycle 5, I have clicked this button, link views, switch to the other view. Here you have the same line highlighted in full context. So makes it very easy to spot things when errors happen or a strange situation happens. You can focus on that and then switch to a different view to get more context information. Other things are you can set bookmarks. So you can quickly switch from one place in the logging to another and crash the application. you can also, like I said, you can pipe in anything. You can see my notes. You can add new sources. So you can say, let's add an UDP source, UDP port 2020, open that. And now it's listening to port 2020. And you have to allow access because it's Windows. And 1 minute more. I could demonstrate sending UDP messages, but I probably screw up the command line, so I won't demonstrate that. What I can do is say you have logging in a HTTP server where logging is stored. You can also drag a URL in the view, and it should start, but it isn't. So if I would have prepared better, I would have started the local HTTP server and hosted that HTML file. Still tried it in the remaining seconds. So here we are. And I don't need that message. Okay, go away. And I'm almost out of time. Yes, so try to localhost 20. Out of time. So okay. So, project sponsored by a couple of sponsors. If you want to help, give me a.